guys, welcome back. In today's video, we'll be seeing through another very important as well as a very relatable case law in your day-to-day life. That case law is Balfour versus Balfour. Sir, why did you tell it is a relatable case law? You will get to know once we are done with this video. So let us begin our today's case, that is Balfour versus Balfour. So what exactly happened in this case? There was a very beautiful couple, that is Mr. and Mrs. Balfour. They resided in Sri Lanka, to be specific, in Ceylon. Mr. Balfour used to work in Sri Lanka and he got a certain vacation time, that is there were certain holidays. So they planned to go to England during that vacation time. So Mr. and Mrs. Balfour, they travelled to England for their holidays. When they were enjoying in their vacation, all of a sudden Mrs. Balfour fell sick and Mr. Balfour took her to the hospital. When she was taken to the hospital, she was diagnosed with something called as arthritis. So she had arthritis and she fell sick. And the doctor suggested Mrs. Balfour that, "Madam, you cannot travel back to Sri Lanka anytime soon." These couple asked why. She said, "Because the weather conditions in Sri Lanka will not suit your health conditions. So I suggest you stay back and take treatment in England itself for some more days." Both the couple, they thought for a while and they agreed, "Okay, I will travel back." That is, Mr. Balfour will travel back to Sri Lanka because he had to work there. And Mrs. Balfour agreed to stay back in England and continue the treatment. As agreed, Mr. Balfour was about to leave to Sri Lanka when he promised Mrs. Balfour that, "Darling, do not worry. You do not worry. Your monthly expenses, I will send you £30 every month from Sri Lanka to you to take care of your monthly expenses and maintenance." Balfour was also happy here. She said, "Thank you so much, husband," and they had a promise, a oral agreement. Balfour travelled. As promised, Balfour sent Mrs. Balfour every month £30. This went on for a couple of months, say 5 to 6 months. He paid it on time. He used to send the money order on time and every month Mrs. Balfour received money. But all of a sudden, in the 7th or 8th month, she all of a sudden stopped receiving money order. She waited for one more month because she felt there might be some technical issue. Even the second month, she didn't get any money order. And this continued. Mrs. Balfour wrote to Mr. Balfour that, "Why are you not sending me money?" Mr. Balfour said, "Sorry, sweetheart. Going forward, I will not send you any more money." And as usual, where do our clients end up? These people also ended up in court. Mrs. Balfour filed a case on Mr. Balfour, saying, "This person promised me to pay £30 every month, but he failed to do as promised." Now, the judge was in a confusion. What to do in this particular case? What do I have to order in this particular case? Asked the judge. Now, when given a thought, the judge finally decided, "My friend sitting here, in your every day of your life, husbands promise 100 things to wives. Like, 'Darling, I'll build you a Taj Mahal. Darling, I'll gift you a platinum ring.' Will the husbands do all these things in their life? There will be hundreds of promises. Your parents also do it for you. In return, you will also give them hundreds of promises. 'I will clear all the exams in 100%. They will say, "I will give you a bike in your next birthday." Now, when all these things are not fulfilled, That is, if a husband does not build Taj Mahal, if your father or mother does not gift you a bike in the next birthday, can you file a case in the court, was the question. So, these things were considered exclusively as domestic and social agreements. That is, in your normal life, there will be hundreds of promises between husband and wife. That time when they promise it, they do not have any intention to bind them legally. There was no intention to get into a legal contract. Unlike you enter it with an outsider. In between these people, there is no intention of getting into a legal contract. So the same thing was held here, and they said Mr. Balfour, as per this promise, had no intention of entering into a legal contract. It was just a promise. So Mrs. Balfour lost this case on the ground of domestic and social agreements. And finally, this verdict came into picture. That is what you will be seeing in your Indian Contract Act. What is that? Domestic and social agreements are not contracts. The agreements which we enter as children or parents or between husband and wife, those things are not enforceable by law. That was this wonderful case law, that is Balfour versus Balfour. I hope this cleared all your doubts, and I hope you also understood the concept of domestic and social agreements as well. Thank you so much for watching this video, guys, and stay tuned for more videos. Thank you.